Today we're going to go through the process of how to grow sweet potatoes in containers. And right at first, when you take the first step, it looks like you're doing a science project in your bedroom. But actually, it's a pretty simple process. You take the sweet potatoes, you put them in a jar of water, you put some toothpicks in them so that it holds the potato about halfway in, submerged into the water. And I like to put a start date on here. And as you can see, I started these on February the 17th. So these have been in here about 2 weeks now. And they are some slow growers, but be patient. That's why I put the date, because I think it's been in here 2 months and it's only been in here for 5 days. But anyway, you'll get the potatoes in the water. You make sure the water level is maintained every day. Make sure that that potato stays wet. And they'll form roots out of the bottom, and they'll fill up that jar with roots down there. And the next step in the potato, you'll see new sprouts coming out of the top, which are called the slips. And as soon as these slips come out and get about 6 inches tall, that takes us to the next step. Okay, our slips are finally starting to be slips, real honest to goodness slips. And you remember we started these on February the 17th. Today's April the 17th, so it's been exactly 2 months. And here's a couple of slips I've already had to pull off the potato. You see how beautiful the roots are? And I had to cut them because they were so long, like this one. See how long it is? And it's fallen over. And when I cut them, it's easy to do. I cut it just like you do a rose bush. If you can come up close on this one, I have a leaf that's coming off right here. So I cut just above that eye, just above it, at about a 45 degree angle. And then I take that top that I cut off of there. And if you look real close, here's one right here. If you look real close, here's where I made the cut at 45 degrees, and there's where the leaf was. And look at the new roots that are coming out of it. Can you see those? I don't know if you can see them, but they're real slow. See the roots? It's trying to root itself out. So when I cut the tops off of these long slips, I just put them in another glass of water, and they're going to root out and be slips that we can plant too. So here I've got two that are already ready to plant. I'm waiting until the nighttime temperatures are a minimum of 50 degrees and above, because if it goes down below 50 degrees, these sweet potatoes, man, they like hot weather, and they can't stand it when it goes down below 50 degrees. You may even lose them. And they can't tolerate frost whatsoever. So you definitely want to make sure that we wait until we're above 50 degrees consistently before we try to plant them outside. So I got about another week. But this slip, you see how it's hanging over here? It can't wait another week. It'll be climbing, laid all over on the ground. So if you're like me and you've got some slips and you still got some calendar left because it's still a little bit cold at night, you're gonna have to take the slip off and put it in some water. So let me show you how to do that. I gently take the potato up. I lift it up, and if you can see right there, you see all these beautiful roots. You see how many roots I'm getting on it? And I come up to the slip, I get a hold of it, and I get down close to the bottom. Just pull it right off. Here's the other one. Okay. I got those two. And I'll take that and put it right back down in there. Oh, he fell off too, so I guess I'll take him with me. Okay. And see, it's still trying to make new slips. This one stayed intact, so I'm going to leave him in there. And I put all those little roots right back down in there. Make sure it's got enough water. And I'll put him back over here. Now he's gonna Acts like he wants to fall too. Okay, so now I got some slips and I separate them out a little bit with the roots. You try to be gentle as you can with them, you know, so you don't injure them too bad. They're pretty hardy. Okay, now I've got four new slips. Can you see that one? That one's a perfect size. It's about a little 12, 14 inches long. It's got a good root system. It's good and healthy, got a good runner on the top. If it was 50 degrees and above at nighttime, he could go right in the ground, but it's not quite there yet. So I'm gonna take a glass of water. I'm gonna put him in there real careful. A nice little slip. And let him sit right here for another week. Okay. Now here's one. Let's see, this slip is way too long. It's a good 36 inches long. Got a good runner on the top and a good root system here. So what I want to do is I want to come down right about halfway where I have about a 14 inch long slip. I take some scissors. I come just above this leaf right here and I cut it at about a 45 degree angle. See there? Now this one, I'm gonna put him carefully in a new glass of water. He's got his own glass because he's a big boy. There you go. And I'm gonna let that one grow for about another week and he'll be ready to put in the ground next Saturday. Now, what are we gonna do with this guy? That's a nice long slip. And see where I cut it right here? At the bottom, I have another leaf coming off, just like roses do. I go just below this one and cut it 45. And I put this in the water. I take off that leaf. There you go. Now the leaf's been removed and I got it at a 45 degree angle. And I'll put it right in here with his other brothers. And he'll start rooting himself up too. So there we go. And I'll do the same thing with these two. I'll get them in a glass of water. Okay, we've been working on our sweet potato slips for the last 10 weeks and it's finally time to put them in some buckets. So what I'm gonna use is a 20 gallon container. And I got these at Lowe's for about less than $8. And when you get your buckets, you want to drill some holes in the bottom so that you make sure that you have plenty of good drainage. And once you got your buckets done, next thing you got to plan for in your backyard is a place to put your buckets. And I built a grow rack for mine and put the grow table right here, and it's got a couple of rails on it so that it lifts the bucket up off of the decking just a little bit so it won't block the drain holes. So I put them on like this. Now the other thing to remember is our sweet potatoes, they are a vine and they want to grow horizontally across the ground like that. And everywhere you see one of these big leaves, they're gonna root down and root down and root down. And that's where you're gonna get potatoes here, potatoes here, and potatoes here. And they wanna keep going, and these vines will go 15 or 20 feet. So you have to plan ahead of what you're gonna do with the vines. You don't want them growing all over the ground in your backyard. So what I did is I put a trellis up. And they're not natural climbers, they're runners, not climbers. So I'm gonna have to encourage those runners to go toward that trellis. And I'm gonna have to gently tie them on with some string and just let them hang there all summer. They'll get wild and hairy looking, but that's okay. Just let them grow. Don't try to trim them. Don't try to prune them back. Let them do what they do because they are feeding them potatoes, all that energy they're collecting from the sun. Okay. We got the containers. The next thing we do is we're going to fill these containers with the same thing I usually do. Peat moss, black cow manure, and some Miracle-Gro potting mix. I use three equal parts and I mix them together in my wheelbarrow. And that's going to be the blend that I use to fill the pots. So let me get the pots filled up and we'll go to the next step. Okay, I got my pots filled, and if you look at the pots, see how I put a big pile of dirt on one side, and it looks kind of funny how lopsided it looks. I did that on purpose. I come down here about 4 inches, I come up here, and I make it raised up. Then I'm gonna add a little water. The reason I do that is it makes it pliable. I want to come about 2 inches down below that rim, see? I'm about 2 inches below the rim, and then I want to make a slope, like a ramp. See that ramp I'm making? Made a nice little ramp, and flat on the top, ramped up right there. The best part about it is you get to play in the mud and not get in trouble. Do the same thing to all of them. Okay, I take my slip. I take them beautiful roots right there, and I put them down here. And I encourage the slip to head toward that trellis. See, I've already kind of got it wrapped up there. And I'll take another slip, and I'll put it right here. I'm heading it toward that trellis. And I make sure my roots are nice and happy, and they're in. Remember, our slips are used to sitting in glasses of water. So I wetted this down to make the mud so that I can make it pliable to get the shape that I'm wanting. And I can get these slips down tight to the ground. And also, it's good and saturated so they don't have too much of a shock by putting them out into the pots. So let me get all these in the pots. Spread my dirt out, planting the leaves and all right on in there. Level it out. Try to mash a little bit of air out of it to where I have an even level, a level container, about 2 inches from the top, see? And then I leave these little pieces sticking out, heading toward the trellis. Okay, we got all of our pots filled, our slips are in place. I watered it a little bit better to make sure it's got a good soak. And the last step is I'm gonna use some of this, this is what I call Easy Straw Seedling Mulch. A lot of you people that grow things from seed, y'all already know all about this. But this is good stuff. I'll take this and I'll cover the top. And there we go. All we got to do is wait for them to grow, and one day we'll come and dump them out. So I'm going to do a follow-on video of this through the summer, and it's going to show the progression of the plants and how to get bigger and bigger. And eventually at the end of the summer, we'll drag the tubs out and we'll harvest our sweet potatoes. These are Korean sweet potatoes. They have a white inside, and they have a taste like a chestnut. Nancy loves them, so these are her taters.
Yep.
So we really appreciate you watching, and if you like our videos, I do ask you to subscribe to our channel. We got a lot of good stuff coming. I'd like for you to be a part of our YouTube family. And if you follow out on Facebook, you can go to our Facebook page, Hollis and Nancy's Homestead. Lots of tips and tricks on there that you can follow along with and make comments and post your own pictures. We'd love to see them. So until next time, always remember, by His hands, we are fed. Give us, Lord, our daily bread. Amen.
Have a blessed day.
Thanks for watching our videos. We really love making them. If you like our videos, please like our Facebook page to get the latest tips and tricks. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the newest video. Like it. It would really inspire and encourage us. But most importantly, share it to encourage others. We'll welcome your comments and questions. Thank you. Have a blessed day.